almost every one of us gets a headache from time to time. Even children will experience it too. This is according to the World Health Organization. The pain can be mild that you can ignore it, or it can be so severe that it can only be described as a splitting headache. It's like your head is going to split into two because of the tremendous pain. So what exactly is a headache, and why do we get it? We have the answers here, but first, we'd really appreciate it if you give a like to this video. Also, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. It will spur us to create even more fun and informative videos just for you. When there is such an extreme pain in our head, it usually feels that a part of our brain, or the whole brain itself, is aching. But according to medical experts, the brain can't feel pain, although it can tell when other parts of the body are aching. The pain that we feel actually happens in the muscles, nerves, and blood vessels in our head and neck. It can happen that these blood vessels or muscles become swollen or tight, or they undergo some kind of changes that put pressure or stimulate the nerves surrounding them within the head. In turn, these nerves will transmit pain impulses to the brain, which it interprets as a headache. Experts also point out that there are two kinds of headaches, primary and secondary. Primary headaches are those that are not caused by any other condition, such as an illness. They are actually the condition. They can either be episodic, which occurs only at one time or another, or chronic, which happens in most days. When the headache isn't throbbing, but a dull, aching sensation, it could be due to tension. Stress is mostly to blame for a tension headache. It can also cause sensitivity in other areas, such as the neck, shoulder muscles, scalp, and forehead. Fortunately, all you might need is a pain reliever, such as ibuprofen or acetaminophen, that can be bought over the counter. Avoiding stress will help you avoid having tension headache episodes. Cluster headaches, on the other hand, can prove to be more problematic. Doctors haven't really pinpointed what causes them. With a cluster headache, you will feel a severe burning sensation behind one eye or on one side of the face. There can also be nasal congestion and tearing of the eye on the same side where the headache occurs. People who experience this kind of headache will have 1 to 4 of them in a single day in a span of a few months. They occur at mostly the same time of day, usually during the spring and fall seasons. And then we have the most notorious kind of headache, the migraine. People who have suffered a migraine know too well how it can be incapacitating. Bringing a throbbing pain on side of the head, migraine can also cause nausea and vomiting. Additionally, sufferers become averse to light and sound. The onset of migraine can also be marked by a symptom called an aura. This could be any of the following visual disturbances: shimmering lights, flashing lights, blind spots, stars, and zigzag lines. Auras can be accompanied by a tingling sensation on one side of the face, or in an arm, or even difficulty in speaking. It's been established that migraine can be a hereditary condition or as a result of a nervous system condition. It can also be triggered by exposure to chemicals, certain foods, sleep disruption, skipped meals, dehydration, or hormone fluctuations. Pain relievers are the basic answer to migraines, but if they don't work, triptans may be prescribed by your doctor. These drugs reduce inflammation and change blood flow to your brain. And then we have the secondary headaches. These are symptoms of other conditions that might be affecting your body, such as allergy or sinus infection. Hormonal fluctuations, especially in women, can also cause headaches. Menstrual migraine is an example of these, as they happen around the menstrual period. Having too much caffeine can also cause a headache. So too does suddenly quitting drinking coffee, after you have done so on a regular basis. Other causes of secondary headaches are intense physical activities, hypertension, head injuries, and too much ingestion of pain relievers. So that's why we get a headache. We hope you have enjoyed this latest episode of AHA, So That's Why. Please like it and subscribe to our channel. Let us know what you think in the comments section below. Thanks for watching.